So we're going to find a mass of a two-dimensional object, and in 2.5, where can you go for help here? Let's go to the textbook, and that is here, and we're in 2.5 already. You can just navigate to that right here on the left. We're going to do mass of a two-dimensional circular object from its radial density function. Let's just double check and make sure that's what we're doing here. With a density function, it doesn't say radial density function, but there is the word radius right here. We have a radius of 4. So let's run back over, and we're going to scroll down. The first part is a one-dimensional mass. We don't have that. This is a linear density function. We got the radial. So here's they're working all that out. What we really need is right here, mass density formula of a circular object. So this is a radial density of a disk, a radius r. And this one's a bit different. It's not just the integral of rho x, but we got a 2 pi x times rho x dx. All right, so let's go ahead, write that in here. Let me make sure I get the letter right. We've got an m for the mass integral. This does have to go starting at 0. We got 2 pi x rho x dx. Now, 2 pi, those are just constant numbers. Okay, so all we need to do is plug in our actual rho function. And for us, here, radius is 4, so a is 4. I probably should have used r, but that's okay. Don't forget you're multiplying by x here. So you got x cubed minus 3x plus 9 dx. So how do you integrate this? You got to distribute first, and so you're going to have x to the fourth degree polynomial, and then just do the anti-power rule and plug in your endpoints.